What is a home? I guess I would describe it as a collection of memories that connects you to a certain geographic location. For all of my adolescent teen life, I've grown up with the same people, done the same things, always knowing every day what I was going to do. Then I graduated and said, I need to do something new, explore someplace, find myself. So I packed all my things and moved to Wisconsin. Why did I ever choose Wisconsin? Who finds themselves in Wisconsin? Well, I suppose I did. If my statement about a home is true to me, then whether I stay here or not, Madison is still my home. And whether I stay here or not, the people in place have still impressed me. And don't say just because I'm leaving that I'm scared and this means nothing. Because sometimes it's better just to trust your gut, and sometimes it's better if I find my place. Some people need me, and some people want me, and isn't that what everyone is looking for? But the same is true if I leave. No matter where I go, I'll always be home. Because a bunch of people telling you they love you doesn't make a home. A home can be alone. If one night, when you were recalling the horror of your past, a devilish beast entered your dream and told you that all of your memories had been drowned with the fermented harvest of grapes, and never again would you have to remember all the pain and suffering that the people you thought were your home had caused you, would you praise such a beast, or would you curse him for his destructive intent? To leave Madison and return home isn't a matter of who meant more to me or who cared the most to keep me in this place. It's to accept all of the good and bad memories and to worship the beauty of life and the people who find in you all that is beautiful. Because you see, without these memories, not only would we be in search of a home, but we'd perpetually be in search of ourselves. To think of a life with no recollection of events is impossible to do unless it's your own experience. But don't take my word for it. Just think of Clive Waring, a man who every day wakes up and can't remember anything.
How many years have I been ill?
About 20.
About 20? Can you imagine trying to have one night 20 years long with no dream? That's what it's been like. Just like death. No difference between day and night, no thoughts at all. In that sense, it's been totally painless. Which is not something which is very desirable, really, is it? Because it's precisely like death. If you have no senses of pain, you have no sense of any kind working either. I don't remember sitting down on this chair, for example, or the settee as it is. That was unknown to me. I've never seen a human being since I've been there. That's the first photograph I've seen of anybody.
And who is that photograph?
It's one of my sons. I can't remember his name.